Woody Reavers, I'm Daniel from Coralust, and today it's Wisdom Wednesday, and sometimes it's good to live in a bubble. And I'm going to tell you why. When you're new to this hobby, information is thrown at you left and right. You're lucky if you only go to one store and you're getting advice from one person who runs a successful aquarium. But if you're like me and you like to hear everyone else's opinion and you ask a lot of people, you may hear different things and you may start to ask yourself, what's the truth? And there's different types of people out there. Like I said, some of you who will go ask your questions and go around, other people who will just stick to one advice and follow that person's lead, and there's other people who think they did it one way and they want to tell everybody how they were almost successful one time and give you advice when their tank looks like crap. So you have to be careful. There's, like I said, so much information thrown at you. So as a newbie, you don't know where to go and what to look at. If you're on the forums and you're an avid Facebook or Reef to Reef person and you type in a question, you're gonna find about 500 responses, especially if it's a common question, because there's a lot of people with a lot of experience giving a lot of advice. And it's hard to sort through that. So especially when you're new in the beginning, you don't know what's a credible person, and before you get burned and you try something crazy, like adding on, a denitrificator that you have to feed, some form of sugar, and it can become a whole process because you just didn't wait long enough to let your tank cycle. You don't need that equipment sometimes. So you have to be careful extremely when spending money, because this hobby is extremely expensive, and it can be. And if you like all the new gadgets, you can spend money and rack up those bills really quick. I've been in this hobby a really long time, over 25 years now, and I can tell you that as time goes on, a lot of things have changed. I'm still learning something new every day, just how to handle different algaes, how to the different light sources, different wavelengths, PAR, blah, 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 this and that. People argued from day one, we'd never grow coral outside metal halides, and then people did it with T5s, and then they argued again, and then they said LEDs will never grow coral, and it's, people hate the new stuff sometimes, so you have to be careful. But one of the ways, like I said, I know that our advice that we give is somewhat accurate, and we do have reputable sources, is because it comes from people who have tested it out. And when you do something long enough and you get the same results, then we start to catch on and then we start to trust you. So I'm an avid reader of Coral Magazine. I don't know how many people out there are subscribers. This is an incredible magazine. Every single issue is just jam-packed, filled with unbelievable information. And you know when you read this, you're getting great sources of information. The articles come with so many credentials, and there's my reef energy. Oh! But anyway, like I said, it's good to know. Get reputable advice, stick to one person, or at least if you join one side, stick to that side. People are gonna argue, like I said, different tanks will have different requirements. So if you're starting out SPS versus an LPS tank versus a zoanthid softy tank versus a mixed reef, nano versus a giant 300 gallon, so you have to remember, there are so many ways to do this. Just stick to your method. Try to stay calm. This takes time. Haste makes waste in this hobby. So, like I said, feel free to give me your feedback. As always, thanks for watching and happy reefing. Until next time.